Hello, I'm Baradwaj Rangan and welcome to Film Companion South's year-end roundup of Tamil films. Ever since Durvangal 16 happened last December, it's been raining newcomers, right? I mean, we've always had newcomers in Tamil cinema, but this has been a special kind of thing where we're not just talking about like somebody new who comes and makes a film and then, you know, we forget about them. But we're talking about newcomers with talent, with vision, and most importantly, with fearlessness. So this year, for my annual list, I'm only going to talk about the films made by first-time filmmakers. In March, we got Lokesh Kanakaraj's Maanagaram, in which the leads were unnamed, they were left unnamed, and they were basically metaphors for the unremarkable people we pass by in a big city. Some people thought the screenplay contrived because of the very convenient way in which things happen, but I thought it was a really good example of how chance works in this kind of a setup. This was a thriller made with assurance and style. Also in March, we got Dora, directed by Das Ramaswamy. It was a surprisingly well-written horror film in which the heroine played by Nayanthara kicks some real ass. I mean, one of the things I liked about her is that she isn't after love and marriage. She actually wants something of a career. I didn't care much for Thambi Ramaya's comedy track, but the emotional beats are very, very effective. The director's success is that he makes you care about a car. In April, we got Thottakkal, directed by Sri Ganesh. The hero, a newcomer named Vetri, is a little stiff, but the film uses his very quality to give us a cop who is ineffective. M.S. Bhaskar is absolutely superb, and I love this director's, the way he uses his formal staging to create a very, very unique mood. It's not surprising to learn that he was Mishkin's assistant. Ettu Thottakkal reminds you of a movie like Anjade, where you walk in expecting a tale of cops and robbers and walk out having witnessed a tale of right and wrong, good and evil, and of man and his milieu. Also in April, we got Dhanush's directorial debut, Pa Pandi, which is about a 60-something man, a former stunt master played by Raj Kiran.
Age 64. Relationship status?
Single.
Don't kill me for this, but I prefer Dhanush's writing in VIP 2 to his writing here for a number of reasons. So I'm not going to get into that right now. But he directs Raj Kiran and Revathi beautifully. It's lovely to see a romance between an older couple, and Sean Roldan's album is absolutely gold. In May, we got Lens, a refreshingly adult thriller directed by Jayaprakash Radhakrishnan. The film played out like a Shankar movie with shades of grey.
You have beautiful fingers.
Really?
What I liked about it is that its message was very powerfully put across, and not just in a preachy way. And the message is this, that there's a difference between a consensually shot porn video and footage that's obtained through a video camera. And this is a very, very important thing in these days. June, we got what was for me the year's best film, Suresh Sangaya's Oru Kidayin Karunai Manu. It was seemingly the story of villagers heading to a faraway place in order to sacrifice a goat. But the road movie turns into a bit of a thriller and finally a bit of an absurdist black comedy. I was reminded a bit of Bresson's Au Hasard Balthazar because, you know, there the imperfections of man are seen through the eyes of a donkey, and here, you know, it's a goat. So recently at the Chennai International Film Festival, I asked the director if he was some way influenced by Bresson's film, and he said no, but that's really just a minor incidental detail. What's important is that we get a sense of the everydayness of a certain kind of life, and every character is marvelously memorable. June was actually a pretty good month for first-time filmmakers. We got Rajkumar Periyasamy's Rangoon, which is a not bad thriller but filled with the factual density of non-fiction. We got Uru, directed by Vicky Anand. It was a lean and tricky thriller that left us with the possibility of several theories to explain the goings-on. And we got ARK Saravanan's Maragatha Nanayam, horror comedy, which was miles away from the usual horror comedy that we get. There was an enjoyable, nutty quality that really worked for me. In July, we got Pandigai, directed by Feroz. It was a smartly written, stylishly crafted thriller set in the world of underground fighting. The fights were excitingly choreographed and set to like ballet-like slow motion. The bloodletting was so beautiful that I just kept watching those frames. Feroz orchestrates mood superbly. In September, we got Kurangabomai, directed by Nithil and Swaminathan. It was a wonderfully crafted tale of crime and collateral damage, what we call hyperlink cinema. It had a magnificent performance by Bharati Raja and a wonderful sense of a lived-in world around the central characters. September also gave us Neruppu, directed by Ashok Kumar. This isn't a great film or anything, but it just showed how even a routine masala movie can be made with a lot of surprises. The sheer unpredictability kept me watching. Then in October, we got the fantastic Meyadha Maan, directed by Ratna Kumar. This was proof that a somewhat stalkery story could be written and directed very well and with big laughs.
Arivar kaanukku
rekka madrunda yaal devadala
enga veete kottu alake.
It's still your basic Hollywood fantasy about a boy and his way out of his league girl, but you could see the director's effort in trying to make every similar sounding scene look and feel different. It was, for me, the most rooted rom-com since Attakathi. It's good to see that good filmmaking in the younger bunch of filmmakers is not just in the heavier films like Yettu Thottakkal or Kurungabommai or, Maanagaram, but also in films like this, which are essentially light and breezy entertainers.
Kadal nama mandela iruka hair mari nalla valarum silippunu theriyala ana pudingittu pononu mudi pannita nama enna da senjala kotti yeti.
Or horror films, I'm talking about Milind Rao's Aval, which came out in November. This was a focused, polished scare movie which told a very involving story without the commercial compromises like comedy.
Na Jenny, idu Sarah. Pakkathu veetukku pudusa kudi vandirukom.
It had superb sound, elegant visuals, and the overall soundness of the craft made this a big screen experience to remember.
Pakkathu veetla irundha pey namma veetukulla vandirchi Krish.
Finally, December, it brought us Aruvi. Arun Prabhu Purushottaman's film was a solidly written satire that took a genuine issue, a serious issue, and did the most unexpected things with it.
Don't know how powerful they are.
It can't be any terrorist organization. Shakil, the media is going frenzy. Play safe.
Terrific performance by Aditi Balan and the controversy surrounding the reality show depiction in the movie made this a must-see. A very impressive film to end the year with. We hope 2018 continues on this note. Have a great new year and keep watching Film Companion South.